Embattled MP Craig Thomson will finally have his day in court tomorrow, facing 150 fraud charges. Reporter Adam Todd joins us live from Canberra. Adam, he says he's actually looking forward to it.
That's right, Hermione. Craig Thomson spoke at Canberra Airport tonight as he flies to Melbourne to face court tomorrow. Now, he is still maintaining his innocence amidst these allegations he misused union funds on, among other things, prostitutes. But he's also hit out at Victoria Police. He says they deliberately humiliated him during his dramatic arrest and subsequent strip search last week. But as he professes his innocence, he accepts he's unlikely to win over the public.
I'm not sure that you can win over the public when you've got 150 charges that you're facing. It's about trying to communicate in terms of where we're up to. There's a lot of what's happening that I'm not able to communicate because it's part of a court hearing. The sooner we can get this on, the better. Obviously, I would prefer that there weren't charges at all. But now that there are, let's get the court process going and have these issues resolved.
Now, of course, Parliament is still sitting this week. The opposition has agreed to grant Mr Thomson a pair, which means one of their MPs will abstain, allowing Mr Thomson to miss Parliament tomorrow without affecting the numbers in the House.
OK, thank you for the update. Adam Todd, live in Canberra. And the first sitting day of the year has kicked off in Canberra amid more leadership questions. The opposition isn't convinced Kevin Rudd's given up his ambitions to lead Labor again, but he insists he supports the Prime Minister.
Everyone should take a very long cold shower.
The Deputy Leader of the Opposition.
There are now 221 days to go until the election. Schoolgirl killer Leslie Camilleri is refusing to break his silence over a 20-year-old murder mystery. He won't reveal where victim Prue Bird is buried, despite a plea from a Supreme Court justice to do so. It's been revealed two possible burial sites were ruled out by investigators last year, including bushland near where the Bega schoolgirls were murdered. Fallen AFL star Liam Jara is a wanted man in South Australia after failing to appear in court. The former Melbourne Demon was due to face assault and drink driving charges. Police in Adelaide have now issued a warrant for his arrest. He's also due to return to court in Alice Springs on other assault charges next month. There are calls for all Volvo buses to be taken off the road after one burst into flames south of Brisbane. The driver and a passenger fled from the bus after it caught fire this morning at Park Ridge. The driver had stopped outside a high school and daycare centre after smelling smoke. The Transport Workers Union wants the entire Volvo fleet to be inspected. Fire crews in WA have spent the day battling an out-of-control blaze southeast of Perth. Residents were forced to evacuate when the bushfire broke out yesterday at Boddington. It started when a mulch pile caught fire, a holiday cottage and shed were destroyed.
I went in last night and the house is just blue with smoke, the entire house, so I just want to get in there and get a few things.
The fire danger warning for the town has been downgraded, but crews remain on alert. As expected, the Reserve Bank has kept rates on hold. On its first board meeting of the year, the RBA left the cash rate at 3%. But in good news for consumers, a number of retailers have decided to keep their post-Christmas sales going until the end of March for a much-needed boost. And the Governor-General has made a trip to the icy continent. Quentin Bryce is Australia's first Governor-General to visit Antarctica, marking 100 years since Sir Douglas Mawson's dangerous journey to Commonwealth Bay.
It's overwhelming. I can't believe that I'm here, really.
She spent the day with Australians working there. A quick look at the weather across the country tonight. It's currently 29 degrees in Townsville, 20 in Brisbane, 22 in Sydney, 25 in Melbourne, 28 in Adelaide, and 25 degrees in Perth.